People leave AXP.
Can you believe it? People actually
go and they leave this great brokerage. Why are they doing it? Why do they go into chat rooms and go so hard and talk about why they had a bad experience at EXP and why they left? Well, it's not for everybody. So we're going to get into that. So make sure you like, share, subscribe. Let's go. Hey guys, how you doing? It's Sasha Chapman here, your real estate tech ninja and realtor here in DFW. If you got a client that needs to come my way, send them my way and I'll take care of them. Real talk, let's talk about EXP. Why are people leaving EXP? I'm gonna give you my top 10 reasons why people leave EXP. Let's go. Here's one of the big ones right here. Number one, the sponsor. They got the wrong sponsor and they don't understand who their sponsor is or what their sponsor can do for them. Or maybe they got oversold on what their sponsor says they're going to do. I see this all the time. You get the wrong sponsor, you don't quite get all the bells and whistles. It's so critical that you get the right sponsor when you come into EXP. Believe me, some sponsors can give you way more than others. Like in my network, we can give you a ton of tools, resources to help you get going. Call me about that if you're interested, all right? Number two, mentorship. You know, I gotta say the mentorship program could use some overhaul. I'm a certified mentor and I mentor quite a few agents, but sometimes you really gotta pull stuff out of your mentees at the same time. But if you get a bad mentor, that's not a good feeling. I don't care what brokerage you're in. If you get a bad mentor, it's really hard to get started as a brand new agent when you're not gelling with your mentor or your mentor's not available. So I have seen people leave because of a lack of mentorship. Now, at that point, you can always request a new mentor. Do it all the time. I have requested new mentees. I couldn't gel with this individual. They just had a terrible mindset. And I tried to help them and they were rude. I'm like, you guys can go. I'll spend my time with somebody else. So it goes both ways on that one too. But the lack of mentorship or getting a bad mentor may be something to make some people leave as well. Number three, here's a big one. They can't funnel all the information. I gotta tell you, EXP is a great place to be and you get a lot of technology, you get a lot of information, but it is a lot. And people get this much information and you need to be able to funnel this to that to get into an actual plan to drive your business. And sometimes people can't do that. It's way too much information and it's information overload. If you're brand new in the business, you're gonna go through that regardless. I'm gonna tell you that now. No matter what brokerage you go to, you are trying to install in your head how to become a real estate agent, how to have a website, how to build technology, how to learn scripts, et cetera, et cetera. It becomes overwhelming and you need to make sure with a place that's going to help you understand that. So being able to funnel is kind of on the individual sometimes, in my personal opinion. I can funnel information. I can just go in a bubble and ignore a whole lot of stuff when I need to, but I have seen people struggle with that one. Number four, this is a big one. They go out of business. People go out of business all the time. It's a hard time in this market right now. It's a hard time to make it happen and people are going out of business. Agents are packing it in, they're not paying their dues. They're saying, you know what? This is not for me. And that's real. I can make a whole video about that. In fact, I'm going to make a video about that where it is time to call it up as an agent and it's time to go. Listen, we only have a 20% success rate in this industry, 20%. That means we have a lot of agents out there who are not being successful, who are failing, who are getting out the business after 2 years when it's time to re-up all your dues and re-up on your education. It happens. Even at EXP, it happens. People are bouncing. Here's what I don't exactly agree with, but number five, fees. Fees. I don't agree with it because you're only paying $85 a month. Okay, it's only $85 a month and it's an 80-20 split. So I think it's more about the split than it is about the $85 a month. Some people just want to go to a discount broker and they want to go to a flat rate broker and that's fine, do your thing. But I have seen people do that and I'm like, when I see that happen, especially with a productive agent, let me be clear about that, a productive agent that is selling 25 to 30 transactions a year, it's going to make more money at EXP because once you cap out, you make all your money and then you got the stock options and, you know, revenue share. If you want to participate in all that stuff, it's just way more ways of making money. But I do see people do it all the time. I've seen agents go to a discount broker. But the funny thing is, when they do, I've had some of my agents I recruited offboard and go to a discount broker. They come back and ask me all these questions. Why? because they ain't getting no freaking help. And they got no guidance, they got no mentorship. This is one of the times where I actually agree when people say you get what you pay for. And I understand that. If you're a discount broker or flat fee brokerage, you're not going to give them all the bells and whistles for free. Some do, but that's not a good business model. They have to control their costs, right? So when people go because of money, these are the things that we're looking at. And sometimes those agents do come back. And sometimes they don't. But that is one aspect why people leave. Number six, they need an office. Some people are not made for this digital environment and this cloud-based brokerage, and they need an actual office. Me, personally, I believe an office is a trap, and I'm going to make a video about that one. Having an office is a big, big trap here in real estate. But some people need that, and they want to be around people, and some people need that rah-rah to tell them what to do and stuff like that. When I was at KW, they were big with that, where individuals were always cheering on you. But I'm a self-made guy. I don't need that. I don't need that. In fact, when I go to the office, I was working a lot less because they don't want to talk, and I like to talk. So that didn't work out. By the time I came to EXP, it was wonderful. I was in my bubble. I was able to be very productive and very efficient with my time. But some people do need an office. Now, with my network, we meet every Monday. You know, COVID put a damper on meeting in person, so we've been doing it more Zoom-based, but obviously we get together from time to time. And I feel like I have a stronger relationship with these guys than I ever did at the other brokerage I was at. But some people need to be in the office every single day. And if you're one of them, something you need to ask yourself. But don't get caught with the office trap. Look for that video soon. Technology. This is ironic because, man, I'm going to tell you, as a tech ninja, EXP has the best technology than any other brokerage. Prove me wrong. Come at me in the comments and I will destroy your brokerage in terms of the technology versus EXP's. All right, I ain't holding no pain. It is what it is. EXP has great technology, but that can be overwhelming. You have to learn the technology. There's a lot of tech that you really do have to learn from the EXP world and how you start navigating that. There's a lot of technology you got to navigate, and that's just real estate in general, okay? You have to navigate technology in general. And EXP has some of the best tech out there. We have the EXP world. We have SkySlope for writing your contracts, and that's free. You know, I'm not a big, big fan of SkySlope, but I can use it really easy. It's actually kind of similar to Dotloop. I'm just a big Dotloop guy, right? And then KV Core is a CRM. And then just understanding how we interact. For those who plug into the technology and get it, man, their business just skyrockets and jumps and it goes. But if you're not a techie individual, you may struggle with that. And I have seen that happen from time to time. My advice is this: if you're not a techie agent, you better learn to become one or hire someone to help you, because going to another brokerage is not going to change that. Okay, I would rather be at a place that has the best technology and I'm just not a techie agent, I need to learn it, versus going to a place that doesn't even have that technology as an option. Think about it. Number eight, the grass is greener on the other side. Everybody thinks that. But you know, heck, EXP agents have thought that who came from Keller Williams is better at EXP. And it is. And people thought it was better to go into another place. When you feel like you're not getting what you want, okay, or what you think you deserve, or what you need in your business, you'll go other places. The grass is always greener on the other side. I've seen it happen so many times, but I gotta tell you this. If you're an agent that's not making phone calls, and you're not being productive, and you're not following with your leads, and you're not lead generating, and you don't have the right mindset, a brokerage is not going to change that. It's not. I mentor a lot of agents, and I can tell you some of them are ready to go because of their lack of mindset in the business, not with EXP, in the business. And that's a problem. So sometimes you might need to look in the mirror and check yourself before you wreck yourself. I know, that's an old reference, but you get it. Number nine, training. Now, I'm not baffled by this, but the training. Because all the reasons I'm giving you are reasons why people are leaving EXP. These are actually reasons why people are wanting to come to EXP as well, right? But the training, let's talk about it. The training is typically online. Most of it's online, unless your network is doing something in person. But some people are just not online learners. That much I have learned. I'm a huge YouTube learner. I have learned the business through YouTube and other means, but I'm a huge video watcher and follow, stop, pause, and do what I need to do. I'm that guy. But if you're not technologically able and you need someone to hold your hand through the process, you know, that's going to be difficult. And I have to be honest with you. That's going to be a problem for you no matter where you go.
because this is not an industry where people are holding your hand and walking you through this. This is not that type of an industry. You have to be self-sufficient and you have to hold yourself accountable. EXP has a lot of training to offer. I mean, it really has a lot of training. But when I hear agents tell me, well, I don't think I'm getting proper training, especially come to my network, I'm like, you must be outside your mind. I'll call them out on that one. I'm like, are you kidding me? My network, we train every Monday with the money badges with Chauncey and I, and we're training people up front, not to mention the honey badges train every Tuesday and Thursdays. And that's just with our network, not to mention what you get on top of it with EXP. And I've actually built this really cool system I'm about to launch every soon called the Real Estate Tech Ninja, that for anybody coming in, they're going to get a ton of training by yours personally right here, yours truly, giving them everything they need in order to get going. We have a lot of training, but sometimes people don't plug into it. So training is a reason why I see people leave as well. And number 10, it's a fit. Sometimes it's just not a good fit. It's just not a good fit. That happens all the time. There's people in their marriages realizing it's not a good fit. It happens. So with EXP, there's a stigma that comes in. I understand that. People are talking about, well, I don't want to recruit. Well, don't. I don't care about the stocks. Don't participate. It's nice to have the options. You don't have to do it, all right? I was not huge in agent attraction and trying to recruit agents. Now I actually like it and I love it because I like helping people. But the stigma out there of EXP about always recruiting is, you know, I'm going balls to the walls on this one. That's crazy. Every brokerage recruits. Name one that doesn't. Name one that doesn't. Because I get a call by 4 or 5 brokerages a week trying to recruit me, okay? So everyone recruits, and then we get this stigma about we're always recruiting, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah, I like to recruit agents. I also like selling houses. Why can't I do both? I can do both. I'm multitasking. But these are some of the reasons, guys. These are reasons why individuals are not staying with EXP. It's ironic because these same reasons are the reasons why people are coming to EXP. What is the difference? The major difference is who you signed up with. Honestly, I do believe it's a big one. Your sponsor is key and critical in EXP because what you get with EXP, you get it regardless. But when you get the right sponsor, they open you up to a bigger network for referrals. They open you up to more technology and more processes and help you level up your game. But these are the reasons. If you are interested in EXP and want to learn more about it, you can click the link down below in the description. Book some time with me. I'll walk you through EXP and I'll show you these awesome tools that I have for you and how I can coach and train you to the next level. All right, peace. Oh, like, share, and subscribe. Share this video. Send it to your friends. If you want to crack jokes or not, I don't care. Like, share, and subscribe. Peace.